Yesterday we had discussed about the thallophyta, plant kingdom part. That is a plant kingdom, one of the part that is known as the thallophyta. We today discussed about the all parts decode one by one and know about the characteristic feature of algae and lichens and what is their function of algae and lichens. We all discuss in this topic. What is the thallophyta? Is it clear? Today I will again repeat about the thallophyta. After that we will discuss the algae, lichens, red, brown, green algae and castors and the folios and the fructicos. Is it everybody? What is the thallophyta? Thallophyta does not grow vertically. I had already told about you. Thallo means thalli-like structure, which is rounded or flat. That is known as the thallophyta. Anything or everything which is grow like a circular form or spherical form with a flat structure, that is known as the thallophyta in a plant kingdom. Undifferentiated. Here, they concentrate on your scheme. Focus on the thallophyta. Right hand side mention here undifferentiated. Was I had already told you about the undifferentiated, very important for the neat point of view. Too many questions are asked from this section. Undifferentiated, every exam point of view, it is very important. Means that thallophyta have no root, no stem, no leaf. Means undifferentiated means jo tissues and they are not form proper organ system. Matlab jaise in our body, liver, heart, kidney are made up of, and in plants and shoot, root, leaves, fruit, flower, etc. But thallophyta, there is a no differentiation of the tissues take place. These are the undifferentiated. Matlab koi specialized partition nahi hai. That's why they are known as the undifferentiated plant body. Undifferentiated plant body, that is no shoot, no stem, no leaves. Sorry, no shoot, no stem, no root, no leaves. Is it clear, everybody? Next is aquatic or terrestrial. Thallophyta are aquatic, means they are found in the water. Some thallophyta are found in the water. Means algae and lichens which are located in the aquatic region, that is they are the thallophyta, na? They are the part of the thallophyta, that's why they are also known as the thallophyta, and they are found in the aquatic region, or terrestrial which is found on the land region. Terrestrial which is found on the land. Is it now very important question for NEET? Which type of alga form the, which type of thallophyta form the colony? I had already told you. Which type of alga form the colonies? Volvax is form the colonies. Volvax is form the colonies. And filamentous alga, which alga is a filamentous, or which thallophytes are filamentous? These are the spirogyra. These are the spirogyra. Salvol is made up of cellulose, not chitin. Salvol is made up of cellulose, not chitin. We also known as the pectose, because pectin are present inside. Pectocellulose, because pectin is present inside. Name the organism of the plant kingdom who have no leaf, no stem, no root, are called. That is the question. Name the organism of plant kingdom who have no leaves, no stem, no root, are called. This type of organism, which type of organism are they? They are the thallophyta. They are the thallophyta. Absence of root, absence of stem, absence of leaf. These type of organism which are present in the plant kingdom, they are known as the thallophyta. They are known as the thallophyta. Very important. It does not have root, stem, leaf. Everybody, let's focus on the screen now. They are the ऑटोट्रॉफिक. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ ऑटोट्रॉफिक? दे मेक दियर ओन फूड, दे मेक दियर ओन फूड इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ सनलाइट विद द हेल्प ऑफ प्रोसेस नोन एज द फोटोसिंथेसिस. दे मेक दियर ओन फूड विद द हेल्प ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस. इज इट क्लियर? What is the meaning of unicellular? They made up of a single cell. They are made up of a single cell. Unicellular means all body function performed by the single cell. Is it? Excretion, circulation, nutrition, etc. Filamentous cell ka spirogyra, one very very important thing. Spirogyra is known as the pond silk. Silk. Spirogyra is known as the pond silk. Pond का silk भी कहा जाता है, pond cum भी कहा जाता है. The cell wall is made up of cellulose, already told. Now today we are discuss about the partition of the thylophyta. Thylophyta is further divided into two parts. One is algae, second is lichens. Lichens are the symbiotic with the alga and fungi. What is the meaning of, focus on the screen, symbiotic with the alga and fungi? Lichens is known as the symbiotic relationship of alga and fungi. What is the meaning of symbiotic relationship? The symbiotic relationship is the beneficial relationship. When two persons joined with each other and both partner are beneficiary, like me and you. You provide me food and I provide you water. Means we both got the food and water. We both are beneficiary. That type of relationship is known as the symbiotic relationship. Now, come to the red alga. That is the polysporin. Red alga is very very important. That is the very very approximately 500 to 2000 times this question is arise, which alga is known as the polysporin. That is the red alga is known as the polysporin, and some example are they given there, Galidium and Porphyra. And the picture of the red alga you have seen on the YouTube and the Google, pictures of the red alga, that is very very beautiful when it is present in the seas and the anywhere where it is present. It form a bud like structure and the sea look like a red color, inside the sea. Like this type of appearance and very very beautiful appearance, that is known as the red alga, due to the red alga. Sometimes this type of question is arise, why sea is looking like red to see outside, because due to the bloom and bed formation of red alga, due to the bloom and red color bed formation by the red alga. Is it clear? Brown alga, they do not have root. One very very important thing in the red alga, you have write down or mention in your notes, they don't carry the root. Is it clear everybody? Now next is the brown alga. That is the brown alga is the fucus. Here spelling is mistake, F-O-C-U-S likha hua hai, that is wrong, F-U-C-U-S, fucus hai. Brown alga is the fucus. Sorghum, that is very very important in the brown alga, sorghum, which is helpful in make iodine. From brown alga we extract iodine. Very very important questions in the NEET exam, where we extract iodine from the brown alga. ठीक है, is it clear? Octocarpus है, and they are the one of the largest alga. This is the one of the largest alga. Brown alga is the one of the largest alga. एग्जाम्पल है एक्टोकार्पस, इज इट? नेक्स्ट इज द ग्रीन एल्गा, नेक्स्ट इज द ग्रीन एल्गा, एग्जाम्पल है क्लाइमाडोमोनास, यूलोथ्रिक्स, यूलोथ्रिक्स एंड द स्पायरोगायरा, यूरेथ्रिक्स एंड द स्पायरोगायरा. इट इज नॉर्मली फंक्शन लाइक द थायलोफाइट्स, इट हैज अ नॉर्मली फंक्शन लाइक द थायलोफाइट्स. नाउ सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द थायलोफाइटा इज द लाइकन्स. What is the lichens? What is the meaning of lichens? When algae and fungi live together in a symbiotic relationship, that is known as the lichens. Suppose alga provide the food to the fungi, and fungi in return provide the water to the alga. This type of relationship is known as the symbiotic relationship, and they together form the one structure. That is known as the lichens. Clear, everybody? Next, lichens are further divided into three types. That is known as the crustose and the folios and the fructicose. That is further divided. Lichens are further divided into three types. That is crustose, folios, fructicose. Is it clear? We will discuss about the lichens. What is the lichens? How they are formed? When alga and fungi together form a combination or together live, they form a beneficiary relationship that is known as the symbiotic relationship. Like alga provide food to the fungi and fungi in return provide nutrient as well as water to the alga, and both are beneficial relationship. One provide one thing and another provide another thing to the other, and they both got both two things. That's why they are the beneficiary. They are beneficiary. This type of beneficiary relationship is known as the symbiotic type of relationship. How lichens form? When alga and fungi live together, they form the lichens. They form the lichens. When alga and fungi live together and perform like a symbiotic beneficiary, they are known as the lichens. What is the lichens? You have cleared already. Lichens are further divided into three classes. That is known as the crustose, folios, and the fructicose. Now we will discuss about the crustose. What is the crustose? These grown tree trunks. Have you ever made dosa in your home? Anybody? Have you ever made dosa in your home? Nobody? If oil is less or tawa is so warm, then what happens when we put the batter or duff of the dosa on the tawa? This stick to the tawa due to the excess warmness or less oil. Then we put lots of force to remove it. And the which thing we remove it? A thin papad-like appearance, that is known as the crustose. Then the lichens which form the thin papad-like appearance, that is known as the crustose. Is it clear? What is the appearance of crustose lichen? They are the thin papad-like appearance. Have you seen you are put four one type of puffy like appearance appear that is known as the crustose, and the crustose lichens form exactly similar structure. Crustose lichen are the thin and very thin crust like structure, thin sheet like structure. It is very difficult to remove. It is very difficult to remove from the crustose and the substratum where this type of lichens are present. This folios. What is the meaning of folios? When lichens is some modified characteristics. When lichens carry some modified characteristics, it look like a leaf-like structure. It look like leaf-like structure with a flat sheet. Their structure is leaf-like but flat sheet-like of tissue, not tightly bound to the substratum. It is not tightly bound to the substratum. Lichen when grow like a leaf, shell leaf-like structure with flat sheet of tissues. Not tightly bound to the substratum when more growing. And next is another modification occur in the lichens. Another modification when too many large modification occur in the lichens due to the mutations and variation, fructicose lichens appear. Fructicose when branches arise. Freestanding, they are the freestanding, they stand their own, and the branches are arise from their body parts and tube like structures. These are the tube like structures, they are known as the fructicose. Is it clear? Like plant. Three types of lichen are very, very important. There is a now evolution happen in this. First crustose appear, after that modification occur, and the folios appear, after again modification and variation mutation take place, fructicose appear. Is it that is mentioned in your notes? Very, very important. Pedogenesis and soil genesis, it is very important role played by lichens is very, very important in the pedogenesis and the soil genesis. Is it clear, everybody? Look at this amazing chart now. That is very, very important chart in this chapter. Here 5,000 to 50,000 mostly question arise from the NEET exam in this chart, in the plant kingdom. Very, very, very important chart of this chapter. Is it clear? That is the three types algal chart. That is a three type algal. Look at this amazing chart. 50,000 type of question arise from this chart. Is it? First is the green alga, chlorophycia. Aquarium. You have seen aquarium. Everybody have seen the aquarium. Why aquarium need after some time to clean? Why we need to clean the aquarium? What is the main need of the clean the aquarium? What is the need? Anybody? What is the need to clean the aquarium? Anybody? Anji, Yadeep, Tanu, anybody? What is the need to clean the aquarium? Yeah, why we need to clean aquarium? Why we need to clean aquarium? Because green alga are present there. Because green alga are present. Green substance is deposit all around the aquarium. That's why we clean the aquarium time to time. That's why we clear or clean the aquarium time to time. Aquarium after some time we clean because due to the deposition of green alga. Is it clear, everybody? It is clear. Next is the brown alga. Brown alga is the Phasophycia. Phasophycia. It has a rigid alga. It is also called as the rigid alga because its outer covering, outer wall, cell wall is very very rigid, hard. जिस structure को हम bend नहीं कर सकते, that type of structure is known as the rigid. You have already know about the ships when ships are run on the seas, है ना? तो दिस जो ब्राउन एल्गा है, दिस एल्गा इज स्टक इन बिटवीन द शिप्स रडर्स एंड शिप रडर्स एंड फंसने की वजह से क्या होता है, दिस इज स्टक द व्हेन इट स्टक द शिप रडर्स इट ब्लॉक द मूविंग शिप, इट ब्लॉक द मूविंग शिप स्पीड. एंड द वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन इन द नीट एग्जाम, विच एल्गा इज स्टक इन द शिप रडर्स. That is the brown alga is the stuck in the ship rudders. Is it clear? Brown alga is the stuck in the ship rudders. Alga we extract. That is very very important. Economical role also. Brown alga. From brown alga we extract the iodine. Very very important alga. Next is the red alga, Rhodophycia. That is known as the Rhodophycia. Rhodo means red color algae. It form the bat like appearance in the sea, and that is very beautiful. When you see the red color sea, that is due to the presence of red algae, which is form the in the sea a bat like appearance. Is it? Any doubt? क्लियर, राइट बेटा जी. नेक्स्ट है ग्रीन एल्गा, मोस्टली फ्रेश वाटर एंड सब एरियल. सब एरियल मीन्स सम पार्ट ऑफ द एल्गी इज इन द प्रेजेंट इन द एयर. सब एरियल मीन्स सम पार्ट इज बिलो इन बिटवीन द सी एंड द सम पार्ट इज एरियल इट्स बीन प्रेजेंट इन द एयर. नेक्स्ट इज द ब्राउन एल्गा, मोस्टली मैराइन. इट इज प्रेजेंट इन द मैराइन सी. Is it? And red algae also present in the marine sea. Clear? Green algae, unicellular organism, abundant. Unicellular means make up of only single cell. That is made up of only single cell. All functions are performed at the single cell. All function are performed by the single cell, like circulatory, excretory, respiration, nutrition, etc. These are present in an abundant quantity, yani a large amount of quantity. Is it clear? Next is the unicellular species are absent. Brown alga, I had already told during the lecture, brown alga is the largest alga. So these type of alga are not unicellular. There is no unicellular species are present in the brown alga. They are the multicellular. Next is red algae, unicellular species fewer. They are present in both type, unicellular as well as multicellular. Some of these are the unicellular. Few species are unicellular, and most of the species of the red alga is the multicellular. It means made up of more than 2 or 3 type of cell. Is it clear? Next is the chlorophyll A and B type. Chlorophyll green alga, it's mean green color pigment is also present. Then chlorophyll A and B both are present. It's mean it can prepare their own food. It can prepare their own food with the help of photosynthesis. If chlorophyll is present, it's mean in the presence of sunlight, it can prepare their own food with the help of process that is known as the photosynthesis. Is it clear? Next is the brown alga, chlorophyll A and C type. that have also present the chlorophyll. It means photosynthesis also occur in this type of alga. Photosynthesis occur in the presence of sunlight also in the brown alga. Chlorophyll A and D type. Red alga also perform the sometime photosynthesis. So they can prepare their food by own. Is it clear? Next day, reserve food is starch. Reserve food is starch. They can store their food as a starch. Carbohydrate ki form mein food deposit hota hai na after photosynthesis. Food is deposit in the form of carbohydrate after the process of photosynthesis. In this case, green alga ke case mein food is deposit in the form of starch. Food is deposit in the form of food is deposit in the form of starch. And in brown alga, reserve food is laminarial. Brown alga, reserve food is laminarian. Is it clear? And in the red alga, reserve food is fluoridian starch. Fluoride plus starch. Is it clear, everybody? Next is green alga. Salvol is of cellulose. I had already told in the thallophytes, salvol is made up of cellulose. It is also known as the pectocellulose because pectin is also present here. Salvol contains cellulose and algin. In brown alga, cellulose plus algin is present. Cellulose and algin. You also call that pectin plus algin. Is it clear? Salvol contains cellulose and polysulfate ester. In red alga, salvol is contained cellulose, yani pectose or pectin, and the polysulfate ester. Polysulfate ester is also present here. Is it clear in the salvol of the red alga? Clear, Beta ji? Next is the fluoxoxanthin is absent. Fluoxoxanthin is absent. In the green alga, fluoxoxanthin is absent. It is a chemical present inside the alga. One of the living chemical, that is like hormonal type chemical present in the alga. Fluoxoxanthin is absent. Fluoxoxanthin is present in the brown alga. And phycoerythrin is present in the red alga. Phycoerythrin is present in the red alga. Next is the zoospore present. Zoospores. There is the reproduction factor. Asexual reproduction occur through the zoospores. Zoospores are present in the green alga. And zoospores are also present in the brown alga because reproduction occur through that zoospores. And the asexual reproduction mode hai, zoospores ki presence mein hi. Aage further new brown alga and the green alga. Generation to generation aage carry karte hain. Jaise one generation to another generation reproduction new species ki origination hoti hai. Red alga juice spores are absent. In alga, red alga, juice spores are absent. Here, juice spores is two spores. No reproduction take place. Is it clear? Spores are not responsible to generate the new generation. Is it clear? Next is example of green alga is Chlamydomonas, Lothrix, and the Spirogyra. In Spirogyra, fragmentation type of reproduction take place. That is the asexual type of reproduction in which a fragment of a Spirogyra can originate or generate a new complete Spirogyra. Next is the brown alga. Fucus. Again, spelling mistake. P-F-O-C-U-S. Wrong hai, F-U-C-U-S, Fucus. Sargassum is a very, very important brown alga through which we extract the iodine. Ectocarpus, that is another example of brown alga. And polysphonia is the red alga, gliadium, and the porphyra. Porphyra is another example of red alga. Is it clear, Beta ji? Today is your homework. Today your homework is prepare this chart in your notebook and clarify each and every point. If any problem, you may ask the question now or as well as any time. Is it clear? And prepare the notes up to thylophyta. And dear division, each and every part, characteristic feature also you have mentioned in, on your notebook. Any doubt? Hanji beta ji, Yadi, Tanu, any doubt? Any questioning regarding to this topic?